Batang Livestock Farm is located in Yushu, Tibetan Autonomous Prefecture on the Qinghai Tibet Plateau, where the average elevation is over 3,000 metres. This vast, thinly populated area is home to a unique breed of dog, the Tibetan Mastiff. The Tibetan Mastiff is a very large breed that retains some of the fierce and aggressive nature of wild dogs. It is in fact the only species of canine that has no fear of beasts of prey. It's said that a Tibetan Mastiff is a match for three wolves. In Batang, almost every family keeps Tibetan Mastiffs. It's considered a particular honor to own one that's a pure breed. Here, people organize regular dog shows. These dog shows are attended by herdsmen from a dozen villages in the farm's vicinity. Fur Bull has brought his three-year-old dog Sam Kie for the contest. The average Tibetan Mastiff lives for between 10 and 15 years. When they're 1 year old, they reach adulthood, and their peak breeding age is when they're 2 years old. Sam Kie has a huge head, long hair, and thick, strong legs. All of these are features of the purest and best Tibetan Mastiffs. Phobul is confident that his dog will be declared the winner of the contest. And even before the contest is concluded, someone offers to buy him for a lot of money. Fubu never imagined that someone would offer him so much money for a dog that, at 3 years old, has already passed its prime. He bought Sam Kie from a friend as a newborn puppy, and the dog has kept him company during some of the hardest times of his life. Sam Kie even save the life of his baby son. Poor Bull doesn't commit himself to selling the dog because he wants to discuss the matter with his wife. Poor Bull is from a traditional herding family, and that means that he's been accompanied by a Tibetan Mastiff ever since his childhood. Tibetan Mastiffs are, by nature, loyal creatures. They only ever devote themselves to a single master. On the plateau, herdsmen raise them to guard their cattle and sheep. Fubu married at the age of 30 and settled in Yushu County Town, but he's never been able to find a steady job. With his son just starting primary school, he desperately needs money, so the high price he's being offered for his dog Sam Kie is very tempting. But still, he hesitates. Thank you. The best season for gathering caterpillar fungus is from the middle of May to late June, when the snow has just melted. Caterpillar fungus is highly valued for its tonic properties, and all herdsmen in rural Yushu go into the mountains to collect it. Fur Bull does so too, but he also buys some from other herdsmen and then resells it to wholesalers. This family live several dozen kilometers away from Yushu. They come here every year to gather caterpillar fungus. Furbo knows that with less caterpillar fungus to be found this year, the price will be higher, so he heads deeper into the mountains to buy some. But he fails to buy any and feels very disappointed. However, he gets excited at the sight of a yak giving birth by the roadside. Herdsmen believe it's good luck to see a yak giving birth. Most of the families living in Yushu earn most of their annual income during the fortnight when they gather caterpillar fungus. The whole family has been camped here for more than 10 days, and in that time, they've collected 120 caterpillar fungi. Furball wants to buy it all. Furball usually returns home empty-handed, but today he's returned with some caterpillar fungus. However, with a third of the six-week season over, he's racking his brains for ideas on how he can lay his hands on some more. Furball's son Zundrop is on holiday from school. He goes with his father to gather caterpillar fungus. Furball's wife has gone even further into the mountains, where she looks for fungus during the day and sleeps in a tent at night. Furball doesn't want to go that far, as he has to take care of his parents and his dog. Before they set out, Zuntrup asks his father if he can play with Samki for a while, and Furball agrees. Furball has to go from place to place doing odd jobs, and as a result, he has little time to be with his son. Zuntrup is now 6 years old. As he watches his son playing, Furball remembers the man who wanted to buy the dog. The man offered a lot of money, and it's certainly true that the money would be a great help for the family. However, Samki is like a member of the family. A year ago, Zuntrup fell into the river when he was playing on the bank, but fortunately, Samki was with him. The dog saved the boy's life, and since then, he's been treated as a member of the family.
我工作忙呗，我各方面都是都有事呗，我没得时间啊。你们俩都没时间照顾孩子？我媳妇照顾有时间呗，那个放学的时候大送着接送着呗。那你跟儿子平常交流多吗？交流也多着，但是我出来带他很少。他特别喜欢我儿子和我，真的。
They set off early the next morning. This is the first time that Furball has taken his son into the mountains to gather caterpillar fungus. They're heading somewhere about an hour's drive from their home. As a place for gathering caterpillar fungus, it's relatively close. Everyone who comes here must pay a 100 yuan fee as a contribution to protecting the fragile local ecosystem. Caterpillar fungus is found in marshy grassland at 3,800 to 5,000 meters above sea level. The climb is hard going even for the people who live at the foot of the mountain. After 2 hours of trekking, Furball and his son are out of breath. Caterpillar fungus is composed of dead caterpillar larvae killed by fungus spores. Little more than 4 centimeters of the plant is ever seen above the ground. This means that Furball and his son have to bend down very low and sometimes even get on their hands and knees to look for the fungus among the grass.
Yesterday, two.
在最多的是六吧，六吧，嗯，你待了多少天了？十天了吧？十天了，一共挖了多少个？啊，一共挖了多少个？一共也30多。30多啊，嗯。这个早还不缺氧。你要一个炸弹？啊，这里有一个。
After more than an hour's work, Fulwell finds his first caterpillar fungus. It's an unwritten rule that the earth must be replaced after caterpillar fungus is dug up. This helps preserve the natural environment.
草皮不是烂了的话，那就是明年都挖着，不是草皮烂了吗？弄弄压一下就没事，还有明年等这个草它已经还长草。150块钱。
150块钱。
啊，找到了。这个怎么样？这颗？中等的吧。啊。
看看你，你俩累不累？
哎，累死了。
Most of the children in Yushu go to gather caterpillar fungus with the adults. With their sharper eyes, they're better at spotting the fungus. Furbo hopes he'll become another breadwinner for the family.
明年开始让他挖，今年能种出啥样的是，啥样的虫子你能看见就行。嗯，他就啥样的他知道就行了。
But it's very hard work. Furbo and his son have only found 4 fungi by the time the sky gets dark.
虫子价格越来越高，虫子越来越少。那时候我小的时候，一天挖40根，价格也那时候没有这么高。嗯，一年比一年涨。
The other caterpillar fungus gatherers are faring no better. It's very hard to find any caterpillar fungus near their home, and this is why Furbo's wife Sandine has gone farther into the mountains. But Furbo has heard that the people there won't let her gather any fungus. He's going to see what's happening, but first he buys some of her favorite fruit. Caterpillar fungus is the chief source of income for many of the herders, so obviously they're very keen to protect it. They come to the grassland just once every few days to gather some.
Mm.
现在来了三天，挖了多长时间？
挖了一个小时。
一个小时。
嗯，挖了一个小时，其他挖的这种。
挖了多少啊？
这个。十八几个。
十八九根。
嗯。
那挖的还挺好的。
嗯，挺好的。
说明这块地方。
再不让挖。
说明这块地方那干什么？嗯，虫草还挺多的。
啊，挺多的，有名的一个地方，这个是。
哦，那现在不让挖怎么办？
我转移到别的地方去。
那这几天白来了
啊，白来了。这几天来了，他就三天的话，损失的将近一万多。
为什么让他来这么远啊？
那这地方虫草好啊。啊，这地方虫草多，虫草好，质量好。
不要三种的。
下一步。
过去打个电话。是嘞。
嗯。
是什么？
下一步的话，他就是看我啊，转移到哪地方去哪地方。嗯。
还是得继续挖。
嗯，继续挖。那继续不挖，明年我们吃啥？
嗯，
Still, his wife is very worried. To cheer her up, Furbo tells her that someone has offered him a lot of money for their dog. But she refuses to let him sell.
啊，对，我现在去转移。现在不专业的话，我别的地方要，还我耽误一个小时就，那我耽误将近五千多了。我估计没掉你。啊。
After several hours spent trekking through the mountains, they reach a livestock farm owned by Furbo's friend. But now Furbo has to rush home to feed the dog.
这一天怎么是你们可用噻？啊，几点？啊，等着去。哦，就这样。
跟着去。
翻过一座，还有下
次。再有最大的事情，小孩上学，上大学，对吧？找工作，然后就家庭，全家快乐呗。
Furbo has decided to keep his dog Samki.By the end of the caterpillar fungus season, Furbo's wife has gathered enough for them to live quite comfortably for the time being.